Well, today we're in Psalm chapter 83, and I want to read to you just the latter portion of the verses. In the context, they're asking God to deliver them out of the hands of the enemy. And if you look down in verse 16, there's a rather strange turn of events in the prayer. Generally speaking, they're asking God to deliver them out of the hands of the enemy and that the enemy would be defeated. And so the interesting thing about verse number 16 is the writer says, fill their faces with shame. In other words, he wants them to be humbled. And there are times in our life that that's very, very, very good. That sometimes if we're not humbled, we'll never find the Lord. And so he's saying that they may seek thy name, O Lord. And that's generally not the kind of prayer that you see in the Psalms that are for the enemies, praying for their good, that they might be humbled and out of that humility and shame that they would turn to God. Nevertheless, in the next verse, you can see sometimes people refuse to turn to God. And actually, it's a thing that's difficult to get across, because if you think through this, when you're opposing God, you're actually opposing yourself, because God is the giver of life and he is the redeemer and he is the only one that can save you. So he says in verse number 17, let them be confounded and troubled forever, yea, let them be put to shame and perish, because there are some who will rebel against God. They will not repent, and no matter what happens to them in life, there are some that are just so stubborn that they refuse to be saved. In verse number 18, the psalmist concludes this particular passage by saying that men might know that thou, whose name alone is Jehovah, thou art the most high over all the earth. Now, when he says they might know, what he really means here is that men might acknowledge him. And we ought to acknowledge him as the creator of heaven and earth. God has created everything in it, everything that moves, everything that lives. In fact, God, everything that you can imagine, God has created. And so we ought to acknowledge that God is the creator. You remember back in Genesis chapter 1, in the beginning, God created the heaven and earth. And when you get down there to verse 26, God created man in his own image. So it's good in the first place to remember and to acknowledge that God is the creator. And by the way, the word acknowledge carries the idea that in the acknowledgement that you submit and you obey and you yield to that. Now, the second thing I want you to think about is over in Acts chapter 17, and we'll look at it very, very quickly. But if you remember, Paul the Apostle was in Athens, and as he goes through the city, he'll see all kinds of idolatry, and if I can get over there quick enough, and he is stirred by it, he's upset by it, and so he takes this opportunity to preach to the Athenians, and here's what he says down in verse number 24. Now remember this, God that made the world and all things therein, seeing that he is the Lord of heaven and earth. And what he's reminding those folks, he's not like these idols. He does not dwell or live in temples, that is, that are made with hands. Neither is he worshipped by men's hands. And basically he's saying God doesn't need anything. You can't give God anything he needs. And then verse number 26, and he has made one blood of all nations of men who dwell on the face of the earth, and he has determined the times of their habitation. Now, all of that, you see, all of that acknowledging him as the creator should bring men to this point in verse 27, lest they should seek the Lord if happily they might feel after him and find him, though he be not far from any one of us. What's that verse mean? God wants to be found. God wants you to come to him. God wants you to seek him. God wants you saved. So when we think about acknowledging him, we're thinking in the first place that God is the creator of everything that we can even think of. And then secondly, he is the redeemer, and his hope is that men will acknowledge he's the savior and they are in need of salvation, and that will bring him to that. Isn't that a great song? That we acknowledge that God is the Most High. He is the sovereign. He has dominion over everything. He has all authority. He has all dominion. And it's good to recognize that is the most important thing in our concept, that God loves us, he wants to redeem us, and he has all authority and all power and all dominion to accomplish that. Hope some of those thoughts help you today as we continue our journey in the Psalms. And we'll be looking at the Psalm 84 tomorrow. So be with me then. See you then.